But you keep us with that faith.
So light the fire in my heart again. I don't know what that means to you, but for Gene and I, that goes back to 1969 when we first went to Southeast Asia. And for all of us, Southeast Asia still stays in our hearts and on our minds because of the Vietnam War, because of the history of America with that area, and with a quarter billion souls that live there now. Thailand was Mesa's first project when Mission Sunday started back in 1991. Cambodia is now the wide-open mission field of Southeast Asia. We've begun a preacher training school there under the direction of Sunset International Bible Institute, and that began back in 2007. Ken and Jean went to Phnom Penh in 2008, and Ken taught in that school for a month. The Cambodian Bible Institute just moved into this larger facility to accommodate the growing student body. Here's the current student body that is training Cambodian men who will evangelize their nation of 15 million souls. 13 men and 4 women make up the student body of the Cambodian Bible Institute. Ken and John Breeden have agreed to teach in that school for 1 month in August next year, 2010. Ken and Jean were in Phnom Penh, the capital of Cambodia, in January of 2008. And they're going again next year. Why do grandparents leave kids and grandkids and great-grandkids for the hot, humid, third-world conditions of Cambodia? Hey, what's our theme again today? Light the fire, win? In 2002, Mission Sunday planted a brand new congregation in the largest city of north-central Thailand. This picture is Wee Chai and his family. They moved from Phuket, southern Thailand, 1,000 miles to join hands with us in planting that new church. Buddhist Thailand has less than 1% believers in among 65 million people. So the growth of the Pisanlok congregation has been slow, but it's been lively. The church meets in their own rented building, and we'll complete our 10-year program supporting this congregation in just 2 more years. The Pisanlok congregation also reaches out to isolated Christians in their area. This is a family circle meeting at Pijit, 50 miles south of Pisanlok, just 2 weeks ago. Remember our Laotian experience? Bill McDonald with Partners in Progress was the catalyst for that Laotian effort. Bill has now moved to Myanmar. That's what we used to call Burma. Can you understand this cryptic message that he sent me last month on Facebook? The military government of Myanmar forbids missionaries and missionary activities, so Bill is doing humanitarian work just like we did in Laos to plant the church. And he's now pushing us to come teach at that livestock show next year. Who lights the fire in our hearts again? Ken's going to be 70 years old in 2010. Is that a good excuse to put out the fire?